Hi, this is Anand from FS here. The topic for today is why the real estate is the biggest source of all black money in India. I repeat, why the real estate is the biggest source of all black money in India. This video can be extremely crucial for all the real estate lovers and investors. So stay brisk, stay happier, and stay very attentive to uncover this great knowledge of why real estate is the biggest source of all black money in India and what are the steps we can take to curb those black money out of real estate in India. So stay tuned with FE Square. Quickly move into the topic. Do you know why real estate is the biggest source of all black money in India? This is because in entire India, for a land or a plot, there are two values. There are two values in entire India for a land or a plot. At first, the value is called government value or guideline value or ready reckoner rate. So in each state, it differs. Some state they call it as government value or guideline value or ready reckoner rate. So this is called value number one, guideline value. The another value is called market value. The market value is the actual value of the land which prevails in the market. But in India, there are two values. There's a huge difference between the guideline value and market value. The guideline value in entire India is always very low, and the market value is always very high. As there's a huge gap between the guideline value and market value, this stands as the predominant reason for the source of, for the creation of black money in Indian real estate. Now let me explain you with a better example. Let's go to Bangalore. Let's take East Bangalore for example. Now we are looking to buy a plot. You are looking to buy a square plot of 1000 square foot land area. So in East Bangalore, if you go and look for plot, the people will say you there are two values. At first, the government value. So in East Bangalore, approximate example, let us take an approximate example. In East Bangalore, if you go and find a plot, there will be two value. At first, government value. So government value, let's take around 2000 rupees per square foot. The market value is around 7000 rupees per square foot. As East Bangalore is very expensive nowadays, and as there's a huge demand in East Bangalore, the market value is almost 7000 rupees in the prime areas of East Bangalore. So now the gap, the government value is just 2000 rupees, the market value is 7000 rupees. So the gap between 2000 rupees and 7000 rupees is 5000 rupees. These 5000 rupees is generated as black money. This is because when you buy the land and when you agree to buy the land for 7000 rupees per square foot, so 1000 rupees land, 1000 square foot land into 7000 rupees is almost equal to 70 lakhs rupees. So 1000 square foot land area multiplied by 7000 rupees square foot price, so it's around 70 lakhs rupees. But at the time of registration, you will register only for guideline value or government value. The government value will be only 2000 rupees per square foot for that particular plot. So the registration department will register only for 2000 rupees. So 1000 square foot into 2000 rupees per square foot will come around 20 lakhs rupees. So your land will get registered only for 20 lakhs rupees with the registration department. The gap between 20 lakhs to 20 lakhs to 70 lakhs, the gap of 50 lakhs rupees is not registered to the government, is not accounted to the Indian Income Tax Department. So this 50 lakhs rupees get generated as a black money in Indian real estate. If you check any city, any town, any state, any district, this situation prevails. There's a huge difference between the government value and the market value. So if the Indian government want to curb black money from Indian real estate, then they should raise the government value government value to the market value, the same level to the same level. For example, in East Bangalore, if the market value is 7,000 rupees, then the government value also should be 7,000 rupees. Only then the plot will get registered for some entire 7,000 rupees, and it will get accounted to the Indian Income Tax government for the entire 7,000 rupees. Then there will be no source or no place for the black money. So from FE Square, I'm taking a big initiative and I'm making a big draft, and I'm going to send it to the Honorable Finance Minister of India, Nirmala Sitharam. I've already written a mail, and now I'm preparing a big draft of how to curb black money from real estate. At the same time, if the biggest challenge here is that if the government values increase to the market value, then the people have to pay huge amount of money in the form of registration fees, stamp duty, and also capital gain taxes. That's why the people are a bit reluctant for the government to raise the government value to the market value, because if you are registering the plot for 20 lakhs rupees, then 10% it will come for registration charges. So 10% of 20 lakhs rupees is around 2 lakhs rupees you have to pay as a registration, stamp duty, and other charges. But if the government value is reduced, increased to market value, then you have to pay 10% for 70 lakhs rupees. So it will come around 7 lakhs of rupees. Then what will happen? The real estate will greatly get affected, because the government values increase to market value, then people have to pay huge sum of money in terms of registration fees, stamp duties, and also capital gain taxes. So the biggest challenge here is that if they increase the government value to the market value, then people will suffer, and the real estate will also suffer, because people are not ready to pay huge amount of money to the government for just registration and stamp duty. So the draft I'm writing to the Honorable Finance Minister of Nirmala Sitharam is that the government has to raise the government value to the market value. At the same time, they have to reduce the cost of stamp duty, registration, and capital gain taxes. So if they do both the thing simultaneously, the government of India and the state government, if they join hands together and raise the government value to the market value, and also reduce the registration cost and stamp duty cost, then definitely the people will feel much happier, and there's no chance for the black money in India. And it's a win-win for the people, because the stamp duty and registration cost is reduced, and the government value and market value are to the same level, they can easily get loan to the full amount of the property, and they will not get involved in black money transaction. As a win-win for government, because the government can curb all the black money from real estate, and at the same time they will get the great revenue from registration and stamp duty, because many people will come into real estate if the real estate is clean, transparent, and there is no black money involved. Then many people will greatly invest in real estate very confidently. So it's a win-win for the government, and it's also win-win for the real estate market, because when people are ready to buy, ready to invest, and the government is ready to help the people, and the government is ready to make the real estate clean and transparent, then the real estate market will greatly surge in India, because many foreign direct investment will come into India. If the real estate is clean and transparent, then many foreign direct investment will come to India. So it's a win-win for everyone. So I'm writing this draft, and I'm going to present it to Honorable Finance Minister of India, so that if they take this action, then definitely they can curb all the black money from real estate. If most of the black money from real estate is eradicated, then 60 to 70% of all black money in India will be eradicated, because real estate stands as the biggest source of all black money. All the politicians, big government officers, or fake business people, they invest huge sum of black money in real estate only. If the real estate government values almost increase to market value, if they have to register to the full value of the market value, then the politicians or the corrupt government officers cannot buy and register for the full value, because they will not have in white money, they will have only in terms of black money. So they will not go behind the black money, because anyway they can't buy land. even though they have a black money. So this is the best solution for the Indian government to curb black money from real estate. So if they do it, they are win-win for the people, win-win for the government, and win-win for the real estate market. So hope you like this video. So if you haven't watched my previous video, please watch my video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to FE Square. No channel across India will give you this many valuable information. So keep watching FE Square. So with this, signing off from Sanon from FE Square. See you in my next video. Until then, have a good care. Bye-bye.